Welcome back. This video is aiming for advanced users, so if you need to, feel free to watch previous videos in this playlist, linked in the description below. In this tutorial, I will explain about setting up multiple servers on the same computer, and later on, the players will join either one using your IP address or Hamachi IP version 4, depending on how you set your server up. The first part of this tutorial will explain how to allow connections to multiple servers via the IP address, in which case Hamachi must not be installed. The second part of this tutorial will explain how to allow connections to multiple servers via the Hamachi IP version 4 address. Here is your server, and here is the router that your computer is connected to. Here is a friend who wants to join the server. In order to join, he will need to connect to my computer, which can be done using my computer's IP address. Except, when he wants to connect, he will have to go through the router. By default, when no ports are open, the router will deny his request to connect, and his Minecraft client will give him an error. But when I open the required port in the router, it basically adds it to some sort of a whitelist. As a result, when the friend will attempt to connect, the router will allow the request this time, and the server application that listens to the connection request will allow the friend to connect. Have you ever wondered why 25565 and not just another number? That's because it's the default port for Minecraft, which means that when you tell Minecraft that you want to connect to a server with a certain IP, Minecraft will expect you to provide a port as well, and if you don't, it will automatically try to connect to the port 25565. If your Minecraft client has successfully established the connection thanks to the port being open on the server side, you will successfully join the server. Okay, now, let's say friend 2 wants to play on a different map, yet friend 1 disagrees and wants to play on the current map. This is possible by opening another port, which the second server will use. Note that it can be any port number that's not taken by a reserved port, which is basically a port that was predefined by various ways, such as by the operating system. For example, port 80 is the default port for HTTP, port 443 is the default port for HTTPS, and so on. So, other than the reserved ports, I can use any port that I want, such as 1000, 2000, 2543, and so on. After I open it, I need to force the server application to use it, which I can do by modifying the server port entry in the server.properties. Now, when friend 2 will want to connect to the second server with port 25555, he will have to connect to 1.2.3.4:25555. Then, since the new port is open in the router, it will allow the connection, the second server application will detect his request to connect, and he will successfully join the server. Let's show it in action. First, make sure that Hamachi is not installed. I uninstalled it before starting this recording. I will use the vanilla server as the first server, and for the second one, I will use a paper server. Let's open the folder for the vanilla server. Next, edit server.properties with a text editor. In the server port entry, I can basically specify any value that I want. The default one is 25565. Let's go and open a port for this number. First, go to command prompt. And using the application ipconfig, under the network adapter that provides my internet connection, in my case, Ethernet adapter Ethernet, there is the default gateway entry. Simply highlight it, copy, and paste it in a browser, such as Chrome. Then, log into your router. If you need help with this, contact your ISP, or Internet Service Provider. Now, let's open the first port. If you need help with this, watch my previous video where I open a port and explain how to use port forward.com. Okay. The port name will obviously be Minecraft. The protocol TCP/UDP. And for the WAN port and LAN port, it's basically this port. For the destination IP, go back to command prompt. And it is basically the entry IP version 4 address. Okay, let's see that everything's working. Okay, the server is open. I will use my Dynu domain. And it's working. Perfect. Now I will edit the second server.properties. And I'll specify for the server application to use the port number 25555. Now let's open the port. So let's call it like Minecraft 2. Then the rest of the details are the same, except of course for the WAN port and LAN port. Okay, nice. Now let's test it on the second computer. So, I will go to multiplayer, add server, and then to specify the port, I will use colon, and then 25555. And it's working perfectly. This is the second part, where I explain how to use Hamachi to set up two servers. First, install Hamachi and create or join a network. If you don't know how, watch my previous video where I explain it. I have already created one, Minecraft multi-server tutorial. Now I will force the first server to use this network by using my Hamachi IPv4 address. Edit the server.properties. And paste it next to server-ip. Now, when I start the server application will be forced to use this IP. Now, let's test it. Okay, now the server is open. And of course, this cannot work. And it's working. Now let's do the same with the second server. Let's see what will happen if I execute the server while the server port is 25565. And this time, instead of executing the server by double-clicking start.bat, I will use an application that can execute scripts, such as command prompt and PowerShell. I will use PowerShell this time because it's much easier. So, shift, right-click, open PowerShell window here, and then, in order to execute the start.bat, I will simply start typing, and then tab, and enter. Okay, since the server application attempted to open a server on the same port as the first one, it gave me an error of failed to bind to port. So to solve this, simply change the port like I did in the previous part. And the server has finished loading. Let's test it. So I will use this address to get to the first server, and to get to the second server, I will specify a port as well, and 25555. And it's working as well. Let's also test in the second computer. First, let's see what will happen if I try to join the server without first logging into the network. Okay, it doesn't work. So now let's join the network. Okay, and now if I refresh, and it's working.